very welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Just have a few questions around sustainability and the business GMR has been into. So my first question would be about urban transport. How do you think urban transport infrastructure would evolve with the advent of electric vehicles?
I think it is the future of the country or any region to shift to electric vehicles. But yes, the infrastructure for the electric vehicle movement has to be improved. Already it is on a priority list of Government of India, Prime Minister's agenda. Especially we engage with charging stations because a large capacity of solar at an affordable price is being generated. I think we have to convert this advantage of our environmental conditions, largest sun availability in the regions, and the technology and upgraded skills of solar power plants or other conventional energy systems is growing in India. There will be leverage between such capacity and convert into electric vehicles rather than motor vehicles on diesel and petrol. There is a great opportunity, but at the same time I feel that it is the need of everyone, and the technology and production has to increase that the cost is affordable. So the affordability of EV vehicles, whether it is motorcycles or passenger vehicles or commercial trucks for a period, but I think the linkage between users, manufacturers, service providers like charging stations. Recently we had all these upcoming real estate projects are going with the appropriate charging mechanisms, whether it is open parking or it is underground parking or a sheltered parking. I think it is a great story. India is going to be moving into that world, and by this I think great addition will be there on the sustainability of the environment.
It is more about channelizing the energies available in the country in a more judicious manner. So for doing this, sir, what kind of industry collaborations would be needed to be future ready and build sustainable cities at the same time?
I think sustainability is a part of our life. We have been always conservative, use the resources judiciously. But yes, the growth, industrialization and the population demand for the certain services has impacted the environment or our sustainability of the situations. In my opinion, with the new technologies including solar or whether it is electric vehicles or it is alternate energies, I think building new cities or satellite cities will throw a maximum comfort in creating these facilities, integrate them together, whether it is water, sewerage, power, transportation, each part of our life can be integrated easily and faster. If we have to develop our existing cities, yes, it is also a need. But we have to have a 3 or 4 pronged program that quickly meet the future needs, redress the existing needs, create the next generation lifestyles.
It's a wholesome approach. Yes.
I think we are going in the same direction, but yes, we have to leverage our resources, whether it is public or private, and convert into a doable action.
Does the group adopt some measures like the use of waste plastic as a raw material in building roads and several constructions? We've seen certain examples globally that are being used. So can you tell us more about this?
Because I am heading the transportation sector, you are making a focused dialogue with me on this, but I would like to broadly explain.
Yes.
How GMR is integrated with sustainable activities. In all our power plants, we try to use recycled water for the cooling systems or other purposes.
Okay.
To quote one of our power plant, which is situated in largest city of the country, Chennai, we saved 1 lakh people's drinking water requirement, and without notice we were awarded MS Swaminathan award for doing so. We were not recognized. It is all the simple philosophy of GM Rao is, yes, power plant is being conceived by government, we are building it, operating it, and we are being provided with water from the system, but Chennai city always dearth of water, we have to find alternate.
Yes.
So we bought 1/3 of Chennai sewerage from the metro board.
Okay.
Converted into fresh water, used for all our purposes of industrial usage. So this is the focus. Not only that, to quote, we are the first people to create largest solar plant in Gujarat, 50 megawatts. Besides that, present our all our airport operations, we use all recycled water, whether it is rain water or it is our sewerage water. We convert them appropriately and use it completely. And almost every airport we design,
yes,
to the extent possible, because we have some reservations, limitations. All our airports are designed with solar power plants to conserve and reap the benefit of the solar system. So I feel that each of us, we recognize, conceive, plan, and make it a way of life. GMR and environment is a focus. We were awarded many awards, and presently ESG is one of the business vertical in the group, separately driven by executive like a business, because we engage each of our business with the corporate and a matrix model. Our priority is to achieve everywhere a zero environmental impact. All our buses in the airport, operating vehicles we converted into electric vehicles already, and our focus is on how we can add value to the society. On highways, you have asked, I missed out.
Yes.
We are the first people to use the recycled bitumen. See, there are certain world standard codes. So, subject to that, and mostly we work with NHAA, National Highway Authority of India.
Yes.
So, certain limit safety, sustainability of the road, and then, as you said, recycled products to be used. In all our roads, we are allowed to use a certain portion of coal wastage from the power plants.
Mm-hmm.
We used in all our roads to that extent. And on all maintenance, recycling of bitumen is one of the priority. We have developed our own technology. We worked with NHAA, got approved, and it is beneficial for everyone.
Was very well sum up in these questions. To just close this conversation, where do you how many years do you see India would need to achieve net zero?
Great question, difficult question.
But
I visualize 10 years. Because ours is a large population, large diversity, and all these things come up with costs. Initially, they are all costly, but yes, over a period, the way we live, our consumption grows. For example, initial years of solar power plant tariffs are 15 rupees. Today it is sub 2 rupees. So it is a change. Affordability, because the economic conditions where we were like a developing economy, our this thing, but the priority of Government of India is great. The vision of Prime Minister to make us and lead this to meet his promise in the Paris Convention or any world platforms.
Yes.
I think it is a great story ahead of all of us.
Thank you very much. It was really nice speaking to you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks.
My privilege.